Hello everyone, welcome back to another tutorial. We'll take a more theoretical approach today as we talk about color theory. Color theory answers a simple question: how come certain color combinations work better than others? It's not just experience or artistry, it's science. And it's this science that we are going to learn today. Let's start off with the color wheel. The color wheel is made of primary colors, which are red, blue, and yellow. When mixed together, we get the secondary colors, green, orange, and purple. Combine it again and we have the tertiary colors. And it's these colors that define the term hue. Hues are colors in their brightest, purest form and indicate the position of the color around the wheel. The next important term to know is saturation. Saturation tells us how intense or vibrant a color is. That is why it's also called intensity or chroma. It has nothing to do with lightness and it does not change the hue. If we take this example here, we have a few dots that start from a very vibrant blue and gradually end with gray, which is a completely desaturated color. And of course, this applies to every color. The next quality is lightness or value. If we keep adding black to a color, we create different shades. And if I do the opposite, I'm creating tints. But you can also create tones by adding gray. And this is how the process works. Let's talk about temperature. The color wheel can be split into two main groups, warm colors and cold colors. But that does not mean that red is always going to be a warm color. Individual colors can take different temperatures as we move along the wheel. This is a warm red because it's mixed with yellow, while a cool red is mixed with blue. Temperature helps with giving meaning to the impact colors have. We call this color psychology. Red is associated with passion and danger, while blue is associated with calmness and strength. There's a link to a blog down below if you are interested to know what the meaning of each color is. If we combine all these qualities together, hue, saturation, lightness, and temperature, we get hundreds of thousands of variations that stem from our initial 12 colors. But how do you combine in a way that works? The answer is color harmonies. We spoke about color harmonies in my video that explains how to create color palettes. But in a nutshell, here they are again. Let's look at this color wheel to demonstrate how these harmonies are formed. First, we have the monochromatic color scheme. It's essentially what we just talked about with tints and shades. It's one color that is being altered by adding more black, white, or gray to create an entire palette. Then we have the analogous color scheme. The rule here is that the colors are neighboring each other on the wheel. So, here I've chosen yellow, orange, and red. But I can also rotate this around to pick a shade of blue, purple, and red, and so on. Complementary colors sit across from each other on the wheel, such as red and green, blue and orange, and yellow and purple. A split complementary is next, and it's similar to the previous, just that one of the colors is split into two nearby colors. This gives high contrast but adds more variety as well. Last, we have a triadic harmony. So we are essentially creating a triangle on the wheel as long as these colors are equal distance from each other. This harmony might be hard to pull off, but you have to remember that you don't need to use the colors in equal amounts in your illustration or design. On the contrary, the rule of thumb is to choose one dominant color to which you add some tints and shades, and use color harmonies to find other colors that work as accent or add details to your composition. For more principles, tips and tricks that guides you on your color palette creation journey, watch my video that covers this topic. Let us know if this was helpful to you and if you want us to create more theoretical videos that help you at the beginning of your artistic journey. Don't forget to subscribe for more, and I'll see you in my next video.